Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. So we have a new furry friend that'll be a new member of the team on the channel. This is Roxy. This is my new baby girl. I adopted her literally like 48 hours ago, and she's the most gentle, precious thing ever. She's a Staffy Pit Terrier, and she's so cute. I need to get, can you smile for the camera? Look, you look over there. She's eating her toy right now, or her toy. Roxy, look, you look at the camera.
Come
look.
Here. Come here.
Oh, she's so invested into this. Really like the most gentle thing ever. Yeah, so me and Garrett were looking online, little shelter doggos like a week ago, and I saw her pop up on there and I was like, oh my gosh, there's no way. There's no way that she's at a shelter. So we went like 4 days ago and we looked at her and I was like, oh my gosh, she's so cute. And she was so gentle right off the bat and we were like, let's think about it. And I went back like 2 days ago and I got her. So yeah, luckily the shelter I got her from is a no-kill, which is really nice. But yeah, I needed to give her a home. I have a lot going on in my life right now, but, and I know like taking on a dog is a full-blown responsibility, but there was no way I could leave without her. So, and I wanted to give her a nice, caring and loving home. But yeah, so far she's been literally like the sweetest thing ever. Absolutely no regrets. So everyone meet Roxy, this is my Roxy girl. She's super buff. Yep, she's buffer than me. She's got like the biggest hammies I've ever seen in my life. It's kind of funny. But yeah, so she's gonna be a new member of the fam and I love her. So yeah, but anyways, today we're gonna go to the gym. I have quads. I don't think you guys have seen this quad workout yet, like at all on my channel. So that's exciting. It's my heavy quad day of the week. So I believe, no, we haven't touched base really on any quad days yet. But so today's heavy. I have one tempo quad day and one like heavy quad day. Obviously, we're still focusing on like control and stuff, but we're really focusing on pushing good weight and feeling it strictly in the quads. No glutes, no hams, straight quads. So we're about to head to the gym. I have a little cold brew situation. So as I, if you guys watched my other prep video so far, you would have seen that I mentioned that I got an espresso machine. This is her. So we have lots of new additions. New dog, new espresso machine, nitro cold brew situation. If you guys live in Phoenix, this is absolutely not sponsored. Y'all need to go to Better Buzz, okay? If you are from San Diego or in California, y'all know of Better Buzz. It's such a good coffee place and they just opened one up in Phoenix, so. Yeah, but we're gonna head to the gym. I have my pre-workout meal with me. I have my little hummus chicken and rice. I'm gonna eat it on the way there because we got a skedaddle, and then I brought my banana for post-workout. Also there's half a scoop of protein in here, and then I'm gonna have the other half after my workout. Let's go. Anyways, hey guys, so we're at the gym. I was really unenthusiastic. We're at the gym now. I'm gonna start the workout. I'm not really gonna talk a whole bunch during this workout, but you guys will get the gist of what we're doing, okay? Starting with leg extensions. Just gonna warm up my knees a little bit. If y'all got prime equipment, you guys know how goated this stuff is. This is probably one of the top leg extensions I've tried. It's really nice because you can add the weight depending on which part of the movement you want to make the heaviest. So like the beginning range, middle range, end range, which is super nice for leg extensions because sometimes having the weight be too heavy at the top can be kind of hard on your knee. So I usually put it heaviest at the bottom in the middle range. And I'll show you guys how I do that in a minute, but getting my knees warmed up. Stan thought I was crazy the last time I did these. And he was like, what are you doing? But this really, for me, like, there's no weight on this. And I'm like literally just lightly kicking this. I feel like it helps warm up my knees really well. So if I make you guys look crazy at the gym, sorry. I like to just do some static holds as well, single leg and double. main thing since I'm training quads is making sure my knees are really warm prior to lifting. All right, so I'm starting with, this is the middle range. My first set is a 15, so I have set of 15, set of two sets of 8 to 12, which those two sets are usually, the first set of 8 to 12, I start pushing, like I consider that my first working set, and then my second set of 8 to 12 is like my main working set, and then my last set will be kind of like a back off set of 1 by 6 to 8. I still push the weight heavy, but I try to slow it down a little bit, because doing leg extensions first, I would consider it like pre-exhaustion of the quads before squats and stuff like that. I used to really not prefer doing that, but my coach has me doing it, and I've been doing it for like the last 3 months, and I actually really, really prefer it. I feel like it really warms up my quads and my knees very well. So yeah, but we're gonna get into our first set of 15. Very light right now. These don't have to be tempo, but I like to make the first set of 15 a little bit more tempo focused just to get my quads nice and warm, get the blood flowing. Set of 6 to 8, of course we're gonna do 8 though. Anytime I have a 2 number, best believe I'm gonna do it to the top number, even if I have to take a little break to get there. So, have to be smart about that. I'd rather do less weight and get full range of motion than do too much weight and have like half reps for the entire set. You know what I mean? All right, y'all, so we're doing pitch darks. I don't even know if you guys have ever seen me do these before, with a squat at least. Obviously, as you can see, I had to finagle the setup a little bit, but a good pitch dark, in my opinion, is one of the best ways to target the quads, to be honest, just because it loads from the hip, which is actually really nice. It kind of feels good on your back. But yeah, rather than like putting a barbell or a hack squat, it loads your back, which can after a while low key take a little bit of a toll on you. We're gonna start light, work our way up. By the way, for those of you wondering, I have these here because I'm short and this belt is huge. So these are here so I can get good range of motion, and it just makes it a little bit easier to unrack the weights. But yeah, kind of the same sequence with these. Set of 15, two sets of 8 to 12, set of one set of 6 to 8, but then I have a burnout set of 25. So that's when we'll do like a complete drop down set with the weight and really just focus on feeling it in the quads and burning them out. Let's see how this feels. Oh yeah, that feels really good actually. Guys, we're doing leg press, my favorite leg press in the whole entire world. I prefer this one for specifically quad focus much more than others, because you guys will see this almost moves like in a C shape, the actual leg press part. So it goes like this. So that way when you're coming down, your knees don't really get in the way, they kind of come up. You'll see what I mean right now. So that was my quad day. I showed you guys pretty much all of it for the most part. The pit shark was honestly my main movement of the day, and then we had some accessory work to hit different lengths of the quads, different parts of the quads. But yeah, pretty much short, sweet, simple. The goal is really just to focus on just a couple main movements and really get the quads tired out and worked. There's no reason to do 50,000 exercises. I've been on this program for like 3 months now, where this is my first quad day of the week. It's worked phenomenal. I really like the pit shark today. I haven't done it in a while, but I might be doing those in place of barbell squats. Similar movement, but it doesn't load my back, which is nice, especially for fatigue levels. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this. I want to do a nice little breakdown video soon where I'm talking during the workout and stuff, but I hope that gave you guys a good glimpse of a nice little quad day, because a lot of you have been asking. So that was it. Yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed it, and we'll do a better in-depth video here soon, kind of talking throughout the workout, but I wanted you guys just to get a good rundown of the exercises and form and all that kind of stuff today. So I hope you'd enjoyed it.